Yes, we are doing it again for the spring of 2020. The top 10 teams in Marvel Strike Force, guys, plus an honorable mention. And if you're ready to see if your favorite team is on this list, you know what to do. Let's go smash it.
Alley flying.
What is up, Valley Maniacs? Valley Flying here. I am back. Welcome to the channel. I hope you're staying safe. Spring is in the air. Yes, it is yet another season in Marvel Strike Force. That means it is time for yet another top 10 list of the teams. What are the best teams? That's what we're going to discuss here. Now, before we get into the list and some of the criteria changes that I'm making this time, I do want to thank everybody that watched this video right here, the winter 2020 edition. And I also want to thank everybody that watched the previous video, the fall of 2019 version. So very highly viewed and liked. So I do want to thank you guys that watched that. So I did mention there's going to be some changes to the format of this list, and it's not going to be a countdown in the true sense of a countdown. What I've done is divide these teams into tiers because I think their placement in these tiers is so close that you can make an argument that where they belong on these tiers. So what I've done, we got the meta tier for the top teams in the game. We got some the smash tier for some teams that are really, really good, just on the cusp of those meta teams, but not quite there. And then we got the fist tier for some really, really good teams in the game, some of the best teams in the game, but just not as good as some of the top teams in the game. So, and I've actually cheated in that bottom tier of this list. There's actually an extra team, so you guys will get to choose which team should be the honorable mention. But obviously, this list is based on these teams and their overall usage in this game. If they're just good on war offense or just on war defense, not gonna have as much value in my book. Obviously, these are all great blitz teams, but if these teams or certain elements of their teams, like certain characters from each team, is valuable in multiple game modes, they're gonna be rated a little higher. So that is how I did this list. So let's get to it. All right, so we're starting off in the fist tier, which is ranks 8, 9, 10 and honorable mention. You guys could decide their placement in this tier, but the first team I want to talk about in this tier is Shield. And this was the first meta team in Marvel Strike Force. Had a lot of synergy. They were good in every single game mode. Not as much anymore. Power creep has kind of passed them by, but still one of the best war defense teams in the game. They're still great in some of the Greek raids, and probably up until about Ultimus 6, they're really good in the Ultimus raids as well. But as you start to get on in some of the later game, you don't really see any of these guys in arena. So still a very, very good team, but very, very niche in certain game modes. So yes, Shield. Other team I want to talk about is the Brotherhood, which is a counter to Shield on war defense. Brotherhood 2.0, actually, I'm talking about, because Mystique, Sabretooth moved on to the Marauders, in my opinion. So I'm counting them as a different team. But this is the 2.0, the version with Blob and Toad. And one of the best war offense teams. They are capable of beating that Shield defense meta. Also one of the teams that can once in a while punch up against the Merc team. So not many teams that can do that. So very, very good for war offense. Also kind of good in the raids. They're good for one or two nodes here and there. I still use them once in a while in the Greek raids because they're capable of, you know, maybe three nodes if you push it. So still has some value there. And maybe you'll see the Magneto or a couple elements of this team in arena, but I don't see them too much in my shard. So still a very good team, but not useful in too many game modes, but they're a very fun team to play with. Next team I want to talk about is the Fantastic Four. This is the first team that was made for war offense, and the rumor floating around this team, they're supposed to be valuable in many different game modes because you could interchange Namor with a fifth character that could make them valuable in arena and raids. That hasn't really materialized. Yes, you can break them up and then replace certain characters, maybe put a Shuri in the place of Namor and make them good for the raids, but just a pure Fantastic Four team. You'll see elements of them around, mainly Invisible Woman though. Once in a while, you'll still see her in arena. Very good for PvP as well, and then still part of a lot of people's Ultimus 7 team. So Fantastic Four does have a lot of value, and another team with a lot of value in this tier is the Supernatural team. and really, really good for war offense. They are one of these teams that could crack a lot of safes. Good against that Merc team, one of the best hard counters to that Merc team, and very good against a lot of these other teams in war defense as well. They're very good in the raids. They have some sustainability with Mordo's passive, and Dr. Strange has a little bit of heal on his ultimate as well. But they're mainly, I think, shine on war offense. Don't really see them too much on arena either, but I'm seeing some people wanting to use a Ghost Rider in Dark Dimension 3, so you see them a little more than some of these other teams. All right, I'm moving on to the Smash tier, and this is for ranks 5, 6, and 7, and you guys can debate on the order of these teams, but the first team I want to talk about is the Marauders, and we talked briefly about them when talking about the Brotherhood, but very, very good. And I think the reason this team has value outside of just war defense is because of Mr. Sinister, because you'll see Mr. Sinister in arena, you'll see him in Dark Dimension 3. I've taken him in Dark Dimension 3 myself. The Greek raids, you can use Mr. Sinister. I think some people are taking him into Ultima 7 as well. So just very versatile character. And that's pretty much the reason that this team is on this list, because outside of war defense, I don't really see a lot of the Mystiques or the Sabertooths or the Strifes or whoever you have on this fifth team, but still very, very dominant on war D if Sinister clones the right character, because he sometimes clones the wrong character. But yes, very, very good team and worthy on the spot of that Smash tier, in my opinion. And another team that has a lot of usage in many game modes and is very, very good is the Spider-Verse team. And I'm talking about the symbiote version of that Spider-Verse team. Carnage, Venom, and Symbiote Spider-Man is the basis of that team, the Spider Bros. And you'll see people taking those three characters into the city notes of Dark Dimension 3. So they have a lot of value. They're a very good war offense team as well. One of the counters to Asgardians, also a counter to Hydra as well because of that Carnage passive. Has some value in the raids. I used pretty much just those three symbiote characters, ran the city lane of one of the Greek raids. I can't remember it off the top of my head, but yes, just those characters, very, very valuable. Once in a while, I will see symbiote Spider-Man in arena as well. So very, very versatile teams that we're talking about here, mainly because of certain characters, but you'll see usage from these teams a lot. And the last team in this category is AIM, and you got a lot of different versions of AIM because of the mix of the minions that you can run. I think the most popular version of this team is going to be Scientist Supreme, AIM Monstrosity, AIM Assaulter, Graviton, and AIM Security. So that is a team that I run, but once in a while I will run that hybrid AIMtron version. Now, very, very good war offense whether you're running AIM or AIMtron or some other hybrid. The raids, you'll see this team can do pretty good in the raids. They do have some sustainability. Not sure if they're Ultima 7 worthy, but Scientist Supreme is on my main Ultima 7 team. So this is a very versatile team. Don't see a lot of this team in arena though, and I think that's kind of their drawback. I don't see really any elements of this team in arena, and I think some people are taking Scientist Supreme into Dark Dimension 3 as well. So versatile, fun team, and yes, worthy of a spot on this tier. We are at the cream of the crop, the meta tier. These are the top teams in Marvel Strike Force. These teams are so good, so razor thin, guys, that I had to group them into a tier because all of them have positives, all of them have negatives, and I think you could make the argument that any of these teams in this tier can be the top team in the game. So this is going to be teams taking up ranks 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the countdown. And again, in no particular order, guys, super close between these teams. So first team we're talking about is the Asgardians, and they're meant to be a war defense team. They can shine on pretty much any game mode that you want them to, but the Asgardians, very, very good for war defense. They have a lot of sustainability, which means they are gonna be good in the raids, and you'll see certain elements of this team, not this whole team, but you'll see certain elements of this team, particularly Hela, in pretty much every game mode. I see her in arena. I see her in raids outside of this Asgardian team. I use her myself in the Ultima 7 pretty much every day. And I've taken her into Dark Dimension 3. I know other people have taken her in as well. And Greg, very valuable asset. That is a sixth member of this team that very, very good. So Asgardians, one of the best teams in the game. Next team I want to talk about, again, in no particular order, is the X-Men. And geez, this team revolves around Phoenix, and without her, they're not too shabby either. Phoenix is so much damage and can be very good in multiple game modes, particularly very, very good at war offense. When I think about this team as a whole, without separating them, they could take out the meta. They could take out the five meta teams on war defense. Some they could punch up a little more than others, but they can take out each and every one of these teams. And you got a couple different configurations of the X-Men as well. You'll see Phoenix in pretty much all the late game arena shards right now. Some even have Colossus in there. Once in a while, I'll see a Cyclops, not too often though, but yes, they're present in arena. Where they're kind of lacking is the raids. Now, they can do a node. They can do a node very, very well. It's the multiple nodes, because usually Phoenix ends up dying that they kind of lose some of their luster. But in every other game mode besides the raids, pretty dominant. And yes, very dominant Dark Dimension 3 as well. I know for myself, on some of those global nodes, very, very valuable character for to have on that. So very valuable every single game mode, guys. X-Men, great team. So are the Inhumans. Yes, the Inhumans, very, very good. And they are all over the place, or at least elements of this team is all over the place right now. Really shines as a war offense team. Hard countering that Hydra team, but pretty much can take out any war meta defense team out there. Again, you certain punch-ups for various teams, but different punch-ups for various teams, but they can take out the war meta defense. You'll see elements of this team, particularly Black Bolt, on every late game arena shard right now. Some will have Yo-Yo as well. That pairing works very well in the raids. So yes, they're present in the raids. I'm not sure if this team as a whole is very good in the raids, but at least the Black Bolt Yo-Yo works very well in Ultima 7 right now. Dark Dimension 3, I took both those characters into Dark Dimension 3 and are very, very valuable for me. So I know other people have taken those characters in. So Inhumans pretty much everywhere, and in my opinion, justified to be in this category on the list. And last team, not the least team, again, this is no particular order, but is a new kids on the block, the Black Order, the big scary team, supposed to be the Apex arena team. And I do think they are very good arena if you're comparing them to your whole teams. They could go straight up against the Inhumans, win, straight up against the X-Men and win, Asgardians and win. And the word is, if you take them into arena, they could punch up a little bit against the current arena meta. But very, very good team. Very good on war offense. Not as good on war defense. You could take these guys out with a few different teams. Raids, I've used them on a node in Ultima 7. And I was expecting to get through one node. They've ended up with full health. So yes, they can be a raid team. Dark Dimension 3, I know some people are wanting to take Ebony Maw. And Ebony Maw is present in arena as well. I think she's going to be, or he's going to have a presence made in the arena meta defense teams at least, and maybe even Dark Dimension 3, and possibly even slotting into Ultima 7 in one of the primary arena teams for a lot of players just in Ultima 7. So Black Order, they are everywhere, and they are very, very strong, especially together with that empowered Thanos. And that is the list, guys. Let me know what you thought of the tiers. Let me know where your placement would be. Curious where you would place these teams within these tiers. And let me know, are there teams I forgot? There were some teams I purposely left off because I don't see their value outside of war, like the Hydras and the Mercs and the Power Armor. Should they be on this list? Are they that good that they should be on this list? Are there other teams that you think should be on this list? Or are there teams that you think should be moved down into or entirely off the list? Let me know, guys. And hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, subscribe to the channel, guys. Smash on that like button. Join the notification squad, ring that bell, and check out some of the links down below. It supports the channel. Share this with your friends. Check that share button as well. And check me out on social media. Give me a Hulk fist bump before you go. Valley Flying out.